middle of nowhere. Seriously, I have no idea where this is, and I'm fine with that. I only know that it's south of where I used to be. And that's not the topic. The topic was decided by Matt W. I'll link to his channel somewhere, probably in the description. And that's because I am part of something called motoblog.com. It's a forum for people like me. And they have a challenge, the Grumpybearchallenge. And the point of that is that every month, someone who got the most votes the last month gets to decide a topic for everyone to do. And this is the topic. Your favorite motorcycle movement. Or some variant of that, I don't know. And I got several, but the one I will focus on is the one that made me realize that I love motorcycling. I love touring, and I'll tell you all about it. Tangen Station. Riding across the mountains on my Husqvarna VR50. Dirt bike is placed on it. And headwind. And I was making good speed across the mountain on this dirt road, and suddenly I saw a place where, oh, holy crap, what wind. And suddenly I came over this hill and I saw with my own eyes a yellow car. So I saw a landscape so beautiful. So I had been there before, it wasn't that far from home, and my family liked to travel. And that was also the occasion. My family had traveled in a mobile home to a campsite on the other side of the mountains. And I wanted to go there with my moped. Great plan, so I thought. It was, because I discovered that site and it revealed to me that I love touring. And while touring is a pretty common thing among motorcyclists, they all have to discover it for themselves. Like, it's not just something they happen to like out of the box. Because there's a lot of travel problems, risks in touring. Most of all, they don't know the road. The same way that I didn't know this road. I only driven it once, and that was 5 minutes ago. So I really want to tour the Norway, Europe, America, and probably Australia too, just for the sake of it. And as a concept artist, I always look for inspiration, and there's no better way to take in the landscape, the culture, the rituals of a land. Other than going through it on a bike, because a bike uses such a good view. I mean, if I had been there in the car at that hill, I'd probably ignore it because, well, I'm in a car, I don't care. know what happened. I didn't care, and I drove there in the car. I haven't cared when I drove there myself. I haven't cared when I was riding on the car, like a passenger. Oh, crap, what wind. And I really embrace that memory as the one moment that made me love the idea of going quite far on a small device like a bike and exploring. After I got my car, I stopped riding that moped, that Husqvarna. And to be fair, I missed it, but I didn't have the ability or the monetary ability to commit to a motorcycle license. But now that I have two cars, I can get rid of one and replace that cost with a bike. So there you have it, my best memory from riding. Out of all the moments I have ridden, which isn't many, I only started doing this a couple of weeks ago, and I hope to continue doing so. I hope that I will get to do what I realized I wanted to do, as I just explained a lot of times. And I'll see you guys next time. Make sure to check out Matt W's motovlog. His stuff is great. And I'll see you. Also visit motovlog.com. Grumpybearchallenge is a great part of it, but not the whole thing. A good place to go to observe motovlogs from a lot of persons in one place. Super useful. But with that, done. Thanks for watching.